The charred remains of Nuke London are the backdrop for NFL action at Plumlee Stadium. It's proved again today why it's the cheating capital of the league by towing every car in the parking lot from the team-owned impound next door. Today's matchup features the two teams who survived the regular season and playoffs. Tonight, they go to war in the mayhem. The New York Tyrants go up against the New London Patriots. Welcome to Mayhem Bowl Sunday. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and see what the team captains have to say.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm the greatest. Greatest, I tell you.
And welcome to the NFL Mayhem Bowl. Grim Blitzrow with you here along with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr.
Hi, everyone. I can't wait for the commercials to start. That's always my favorite part.
We've got the biggest game of the year here, Bricks. Two teams battling each other in the ultimate battle of death.
Yeah, but those butt wiper beer commercials with the horses, they make me want to cry, Grim.
And it's first and 10. The Strawberry Fields dirty trick is my mentor Huntry coming on, and the quarterback unleashes, and he's, oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peppy.
Chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
First and 10. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Second down and 10. Except maybe four on that play. Third down and 6. First and 10. 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. And this game is up for grabs. Second down and 6. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the changes, Gordon, did it? How good can it be?
Third and 2. Second and 3. 2 minutes remain in the half.
Wait, I gotta take a dump.
Second and 3. Timeout to stop the clock. They have 2 left. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! For the extra point. It's good. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. And it's 1st and 10. And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the path he's taking upfield. He broke free and has open field in front of him. The coach isn't liking that call. Oh, his head just exploded. Uses a time warp dirty trick to erase that last play.
Having all those team physicists really paid off.
And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. And he pulled a one deep dirty trick. This play is usually good for him. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, man.
Seriously, man, you think you go toe-to-toe with me? You get my grill, I'll ruin your world. Ruin it.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. That kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. Thank you. first and 10. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have to meet at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And that'll be second down and 4. And that is caught for a first down. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up with a crack.
It's called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass out of bounds before he gets fried. Second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. We're at the Mayhem Bowl, and the third quarter is about to start. Neither team really pulling away.
What's about who wants it more, Grim? And who's going to run into a saw blade by accident? And who's going to be the unlucky bastard that steps on the line? And who's...
Yeah, we get the idea. And why don't you be the unlucky bastard that falls down the stairs on your way to get your hot dog?
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. A returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Briggs. It means he can return it for me. You know what? Never mind. And it's first and 10.
Didn't cripple him.
It certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. We know this quarterback likes to play with soft balls, but the defense, they're playing with big balls and just crushed his balls.
That's a lot of balls, Ben.
Second down in a very lot. The QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the middle now. You know what happened?
Third down in. The punter is warming up. Six-yard gain on that catch.
Oh, boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
The defense saw that play coming a mile away and snuffed it out. They might consider calling a kill-the-ref play. Just saying. Says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys. first and 10. And the defense just knocked the wind out of that quarterback. Second down and more than the QB would like. Return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. And he runs it for 4 yards. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Dunya, was that you?
Hey, follow me.
That's a catch for a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Says, I don't think so. Third down and 6.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. Fourth quarter, and we're at the 2-minute warning.
2 minutes until what?
And it's first and 10.
One, not two.
And the defense holds that pass play to only 2 yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go.
Two.
He is rolling thunder and pouring pain. It's, I hope you covered your ears, Brick. Oh, great throw. Great catch. And that puts 6 points on the board.
The defense could do anything to stop a throw that good, man.
You mean aside from driving the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Tartar. And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
first and 10. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. A timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. And it's first and 10. Says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. When in a hurry up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And he was stuck to him like glue. Quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Ben, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the... Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
And that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football.
Oh, that was a great throw and a great catch.
Yeah, but it was an interception.
Oh, yeah. What is this, 80s wrestling?
Ghost.
And it's first and 10.
One, two.
They've used a strawberry field dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Ben?
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. The nuked London Hatriots win today's game. And they've done it. They've won the Mayhem Bowl to become the Intergalactic Champions.
I'm getting the hell out of here. See you next season, jerks.
Hey, wait, you still have to do the post-game, Bricks.
Why you do the post-game?
Let's hear from the MVP.
Someone get Bricks back here.
Once again, the folks at Evil Zan thank our viewing audience and the Newton Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off. And that's a wrap. All right, that's another season, boys. Good job. Hey, Bricks, let the cheerleaders in, huh? Hey, Junior, start rolling.
On it, boss.
I love you guys. We got the best gig in the world.
Hey, stow it, dipshit. Start filling the hot tub. Hey, where's the champagne?
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Heart Corporation. They get it right every up.